Hi, and welcome to this webinar about studying engineering at LIU. My name is Olivia Chamon, and I'm from Stockholm, Sweden. I study computer science master here at LIU, and this is my friend Niraj.
Hi, my name is Niraj, and I'm from India, and I study sustainability engineering and management. So let's talk about our schedule. So how was your schedule during your studies?
I guess the schedule is a bit tough, like at the computer science master. I mean, you have a lot of things scheduled and you will have labs maybe a bit later than you might have had before. How about you?
I was lucky enough. I mean, I did not have a very tight schedule. My day used to start around 8 a.m. The classes used to start around 8 a.m. Yeah. And it used to get over by 5 p.m. That's it. And not all days we had classes. So usually there will be like 3 or 4 days in a week, the classes. That's it.
I guess, I mean, you have to, even like when you don't have classes, you have to be studying. So, I mean, it's the same for me. Like, you will have one day off, but like, you're still sitting there studying.
Yeah, because the university, the full-time studies, what the university says is like 40 hours or
exactly.
40
so 40 hours
per week.
Yeah, so they expect that, and like, they expect you to study like during those hours.
Yes, definitely.
All right, but like, tell me some more about group work. How has that looked for you here at LIU?
Group work was really fun because we did not have this kind of group works before in India when I was doing my bachelor's, and this was something new for me. So group work was exciting. I got to meet a lot of new people. I got to socialize and network with them, and I got to understand different perspectives of different people to solve the same problem. It was fun, but it is challenging as well. You have to know who does what, and you have to be in the same frequency as the other people in the group. So that is the only drawback, but I did not find that to be happening with my case. What about you?
I guess I'm quite used to group work, like from my bachelor and even high school. So we did a lot of group work here in Sweden. But you have to be really mindful of like who you choose as your partner and that you guys sync and are able to work together. We have like quite a lot of group work here at LIU, and we can do that. Like, it comes in different forms. For example, like if you are doing labs, we will often be doing the labs in pairs of two, and that's oftentimes mandatory. We can also have like when doing projects, you can be like 4 or 5 people. There are even courses where you are like 20 people.
What?
One of the courses I'm taking right now, like we are 20 people in our group.
That's a huge group.
You really have to plan a lot, and like everyone has to do their part.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, even I had groups of number 4 or 5 maximum, not 20 people. That's
I think it's an exception.
Nice. What about the seminars? How often do you have seminars, and how do you prepare for the seminars?
I mean, it depends. Like, not all courses have seminars, but some do, and oftentimes the seminars will be mandatory, so you have to be there, and you will have to oftentimes read something beforehand or write something beforehand, and that will be your ticket into the seminar, because if you haven't done the work before, you will oftentimes not be allowed to be part of the seminar, at least at the computer science major. Yeah, I think those are like quite fun. Like, you get to talk with a lot of people. You end up discussing. Like, it isn't as scary as they sound. At least that's what I think. Okay. But I guess, like, is that like different for you?
I mean, for the first couple of subjects, it was scary. I mean, I was afraid to go on stage and talk to like 30 people in the class, and that was a little awkward for me. But I mean, I was used to it because, as I said, we had seminars and group works for almost all the subjects in my course. So I was pretty much got used to it.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's fun. It's fun if everything goes according to your plan. It's not if it doesn't.
So, I mean, let's talk a bit about thesis.
Yeah.
You've just finished your thesis.
Yeah.
How was that?
It was fun. It was fun. It was scary. It was challenging. I gained a lot of knowledge during the 7 months. It took me 7 months to complete my master thesis. My thesis topic was challenges of circular startups who are developing circular business models.
Mm-hmm.
So I got to meet a lot of people who are in this field. So we interviewed like 25 to 30 people, and most of them were CEOs and co-CEOs.
Mm-hmm.
And it was exciting and fun. And I did my thesis in the university. So that was an interesting part as well, because I got a lot of support from the supervisors and the examiners, without which I wouldn't have completed the thesis this soon. How about you?
So, I mean, yeah, I'm doing my thesis at a company. So that's like outside of Liu. I also did my bachelor thesis at a company. So, I mean, I'm only used to that. I have never done it at LIU. So I don't know how that looks, but I think that doing it at a company is great. So you definitely have the choice of doing so. You're able to like get new contacts and even like get a job afterwards. And the way it works is oftentimes that the companies will publish the thesis topics for each semester. And then like all students are welcome to apply. And then you send in your CV and maybe a like personal letter telling them why you want to do that particular thesis. My thesis is in the field of machine learning. And that's also my specialization at the computer science master. But you are able to choose like whichever topic you want as long as it's approved by Liu. So you can do it in like security or machine learning or networking.
That's really awesome to hear.
Yeah. And I mean, the thesis is like, it's supposed to be 20 weeks long. So, and that is all up to you, how you plan it out. So you're in charge of like setting all of the deadlines and everything and writing the report. You will have some help from your examiner, but like they are not there to tell you what to do. You have to do it yourself. Do you have like anything else to like add to that?
I think that's it.
I can
actually add this. I did my thesis with my partner, so I had a partner along with me, which was a really she was really supportive, and it's difficult to do a thesis unless you are very determined to do a thesis alone. It's pretty easier if you have a partner where you can, I mean, the burden on you will be reduced drastically. So
I guess, I mean, it depends. Like, the thesis will still have to be, like, it has to be bigger when you're doing it in pairs of two. And I think like here at Liu, at least like in my field, it's quite common to do it in pairs of two. So I guess that was all from us.
Yes.
And we hope we answered some of your questions and that we will see you at Liu next year. Bye.
Bye.